Welcome to Python Coding, Episode 3, Dialogues and Playing a Video. This week's episode, it gets interesting. Our add-on starts to take shape as we show dialogues, get user interaction, and even play a video in Kodi.
Right, as we are going to be doing something totally different today, I think what we'd do is I'll show you a little trick, if you probably know it already, but if we highlight from Diesel, number 12, so just click in the side bit and it sort of highlights the whole row. And then hold down shift and press down, all the way down, or page down, whichever. So you've got the whole thing highlighted. If you then click on, edit and comment, which is just underline, and do toggle comment. And it will comment out the whole thing. Excellent. So I'm just going to put a little bit at the top saying week 1 and 2 work if statements. So just chuck that in there somewhere and leave a gap at the top for our new stuff.
Good.
Brilliant. Excellent. Now, another thing that I'd like you to get up on your screen. Can you see my screen at the minute?
Yep, I'm looking at it. Yep.
Okay. Okay. Head on over to noobsandnerds.com and on the development menu, if you scroll down, you're going to come to a submenu with add-on development, and in the submenu there is Kodi command resources. Now if you go to that page, there's a lot of useful pages here in this development section, so well worth popping in here, but definitely well worth bookmarking this page here. Add it to your favorites, the Kodi command resources, because what you've got in here is links to all the various sites, lots of like wiki pages and things like that. And they will list all the different functions that you can use in your Python coding. There's some really, really useful bits and bobs in here. And you're going to find yourself referring to this a lot. You know, I've been coding for a little while now, and I still refer to this almost on a daily basis, because there are a lot of different commands out there. But this one here is what we're going to focus on today, the top one, the pydocs. Now this one, if we click on this, you're going to see, I mean, it looks a bit dated, you know, it's not graphically rich, you know, the web page or anything like that, but the information here is very good. So, first thing we've got to do is choose what version of Kodi or XBMC we're coding on. Now obviously we're going to do Jarvis, just choose the relevant one for you. You're going to find, to be honest, that even if we choose one back as far as XBMC 12, which was Frodo, so four versions back, you're going to find that the commands really don't differ that much. They don't change all that often. But always stick with the latest one so you make sure you have got the actual latest stuff. Right, so let's click on the Kodi 16 Jarvis, because that's the current version of Kodi I'm using here in these guides. And you'll notice we've now got a list of different modules. If you've been following these guides, you may be familiar with a couple of these. The first two, XBMC and XBMC GUI. Now we imported these in our test add-on code. So the XBMC, we use the log function from that. And if we just click on that, I'll just give you a very, very brief look at the sort of things you can do in here. This gives you lots of different functions and classes that you can use in Kodi. A lot of the useful ones are things like execute built-in, you know, the log function, obviously we know about. You've got playlist things in here, you can play items, but you know, we'll come more into that later. So we're just going to go back and explain the others. So XBMC GUI, now this is more kind of skin related, I suppose, mostly. It's also got the dialogue functions in here. So when you have a little box that pops up, little dialogue box to say, do you want to install this, yes, no, or click OK to continue, that sort of thing can be called from that module. And then we've got the XBMC plugin, XBMC add-on ones. Those two, as you might have guessed, relate more to add-on stuff. So for example, there's a function in there that you can call, and you can find out things like the physical path of a particular add-on, maybe the description of an add-on, the title of an add-on given the ID. You can find out the path to the icon, all kinds of things like that. And the XBMC VFS is the virtual file system. So we're definitely going to this in another guide, because that's very useful, and it allow you to use paths such as remote paths and things like that. But for now, we're going to look at the XBMC GUI one just there. And you know, these pages, they're very basic, and they can be a bit daunting, to be honest. I quite often have to read them a number of times until I've fully grasped what I'm doing, because the examples are not always that straightforward. They're not very noob friendly, to be honest, but not very user friendly. But all the information is here. This is the only place you're going to need to come to find this particular information. So you're just going to have to get used to the old school layout, I'm afraid, and the wording that's used. So in our simple example here, we're going to use the dialogue class. Now, I mentioned class as opposed to function. They're very similar. It's hard to explain. Class is similar to, it's cross between a function and a module, to be honest. It's kind of a little bit like, if you think of a module, which contains functions, it's its own file. A class is essentially the same as that, but it's held inside a module. So you could have a class which has lots of different functions in there that you can do. So for example, if we choose this class here, the dialogue one, so we do XBMC GUI dot dialogue, open close brackets, and then we could put a dot after that to choose a particular function inside that class. So, I mean, the one we're going to be using is, let's have a look down here. Okay, yeah. So, as an example, you know, it's got a little example at the bottom here. So it tells you, what you do is you call it as a variable. You call the variable dialogue, or whatever you want to call it, and make that equal to the class here, the dialogue class. You may accidentally hear me refer to it as a function, and it behaves like a function, but actually it is a class. So if you hear me saying that, sorry, I do mean class. And then we're actually using it in the code there, but I'll go more in depth in that in a minute. We'll look into how to use that now. Let's go into the code. So okay. XBMC GUI dot, and then on that page, if you was to have a look, you'd see that there's one called dialogue with a capital D. Dialogue. If I got to spell that right, dialogue. And then you do the open close brackets, and da, 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 and then you would do dot. Okay, and then some open brackets. Ends up being a really long-winded thing that you're going to type out. Very confusing. So what we want to do is make that shorter. All right, so we get rid of that okay business. We just stick with XBMC GUI dot dialogue with the open close brackets, and at the start we're going to turn that into a variable. So we're just going to call it dialogue equals. So now, whenever we want to call our dialogue, we don't need to type in all that rubbish there. We just type in dialogue. Dialogue. And then we can do dot okay, because we're going to do one that says some sort of message, and it's just an okay button.
Okay.
So you open brackets, and in here, the first thing that you put in, so you're going to need a couple of little quotation marks. We'll just do hello world, and then you're going to need a comma after that, because this this needs a minimum of two variables in there, two parameters in there. So the first one is the title, and then after the comma we just put another couple of quotation marks in there, and we can put in something like, this is a test, click OK to continue.
So dialogue has to have a capital D when we're calling it?
No, when we're calling it, it just needs to have however you've spelt the variable on, so it'd be a lowercase in my example there.
No, but do you see how it's XBMC GUI dot dialogue with a capital D?
Yeah.
That doesn't matter then?
That bit, yeah, that does need to be uppercase D, yep.
Okay.
But obviously when we call it further down, we're just calling the actual variable, the dialogue, with the all lowercase.
Yep. Yeah, we can name that whatever we want. Okay.
Yeah. So I'm going to click on it and see if I get an error. Yay, mine works.
Just finishing mine here.
I'm quite surprised I didn't get any errors. That is two lines I've put in there, which, you know, can quite often go wrong on this. Yeah, it works.
Hello world. This is a test. Click OK to continue. Okay.
Fabulous.
Sweet. That's freaking cool.
Yeah.
I love clicking stuff.
Yeah, me too. Yeah. So that's pretty much a one-liner now. Now we've got that variable set up.
Wow.
So let's do another one below that. Let's do dialogue dot yes, no, or one word, yes, no. And it's exactly the same principle. You need a title to start with. So we'd do yes, no, question. And we'd just do click yes or no. Can you see that okay?
Yep, and I'm good. So I'm gonna trust we're testing again?
Yeah, give it a go. See what happens. So we should now get the okay first. Yeah.
I'm good. Yeah.
Perfect. So how easy is that?
Totally easy.
Yeah. That's brilliant. Now, now the yes, no one is cool. It's really useful. Unfortunately, the only option with yes no is, I mean, you can rename the yes and no, but you've only got two options, so you can't have yes no maybe. You know, it's very limited in that aspect. So if you need something that has multiple options, you'd have to code it up yourself from scratch, basically. Which is a pain in the arse. But what we can do on this, might as well do it while we're here, you can add extra parameters at the end. So where we've got click yes or no, if you put a comma after that, you can then type yes label equals, and you should see it goes orange, and then quotation marks, whatever you want. Let's do,
how about just colors like blue or green?
Continue.
You do whatever.
All right. So yes label continue, and we do comma and then no label equals, open the quotation marks, stop. Yeah. You'll see I've put spaces after commas. Just makes it look a little tidier, but you don't have to.
Mine didn't go yellow for some reason.
Have you got
Actually, hold on.
quotation?
Maybe it might be. I'm going to just change, make sure I'm using proper, because I opened it fresh. So maybe I'm not getting, where the hell was that again? It's going to be one of those days. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm in Python.
So
It's weird that
which
mine's a different color. Yes label is white for me.
yes, oh, have you put an equals in?
I put what?
Equals, yes label equals.
Yep.
And then
Doing exactly the same as you, then the string.
have you put quotation marks for the continue?
Yep. Maybe
How?
mine's, but the thing is too, Lee, yours, you know how yours is kind of like a pale yellow?
Yeah.
Mine's green, so maybe that's why.
Maybe. Maybe that's it. Oh
We'll
yeah,
see if it doesn't
I
work.
might have a different color scheme set up, maybe.
Oh wait, I do have one question for you. Is label capital L?
No, it just looks it on here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Never mind then. I thought maybe it was that.
No, that's fooled me before, that L. I've deliberately not used L a lot of times just 'cause it confuses me. The font they've
Okay,
used is terrible. Yeah.
I'll caught up there, Lee.
Okay, brilliant. So if we save that and then try running it and just make
Okay.
sure that works.
Yep, totally did. Got continue and stop.
Perfect. Continue or stop. So at the minute it doesn't matter what you press because it does exactly the same. There's no more code to do. Now what that means though, we can actually make a pretty basic plugin with this, pretty basic add-on already, a little very basic video add-on, which is what we're going to do today.
Cool.
Because yes, no, what that does when you call that the yes or no, it's going to either send back the number one, which is true, basically, one or true, they both mean the same thing. Oh, do you need to get that?
No.
No. yeah, so it'll send back one or zero. So one is the yes. So if you click continue, it'll send back the number one. And if you click no, it'll send back the number zero. Yeah. So
Yep.
what we could do here is we need to make that into a variable, basically, because we need
That's a lot
to.
of words.
We need to assign, we need to assign it to something so that we can say, is that yes or is that no? Yeah, so for example, if we do choice equals dialogue yes no. So I'm just going to comment out that one above because we don't actually need that one there, the okay one. So we've got choice equals dialogue yes no, blah de blah de blah de blah. So that is going to make choice one or zero, depending on what button we press.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Makes complete sense, yes.
Yep. Okay. So what we can do in that case is, if you remember how to use the if statement, we can do if choice. Now there's two ways of doing this. We could do, well, actually, it's three ways. We could do if choice is equal to one, like that. Yeah, so that means if it's yes, if it's continue, yeah. We could also do if choice is equal to true. Ooh, spell true, right? True with a capital T. That's exactly the
Okay.
same. Yeah. Or we can get rid of all that, make it much shorter, and just say if choice. Yeah, because if it was naught, naught, sorry, if it was zero, if it was zero, that in coding terms, that means choice is nothing. Yeah, it's zero. Mm-hmm. So that would basically come back as false. It wouldn't do that statement. It would say, nah, choice is nothing. So we won't bother doing that. But if it's one, it will say, it is something. It's number one. So you could do it, you could do it this way. This is how I often do it in my code, but we do equals to one, just to save any confusion for now.
For us noobs, yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah. And then I'm just going to copy, I'm going to cut that dialogue OK one, and I'm going to paste it in there. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'll change the heading to...
What's the fastest way to undo? Oh, Control Z.
Oh, Control, yep. Control Z.
I actually deleted that line.
Okay.
Okay. Well, that was my fault. Okay, just keep on going. I'm just going to grab while you're talking.
Okay, yep. So I'm just going to call that you pressed... Going to show you something else as well. Right. With these dialogues, so at the moment, in the main message area, we're just sending one long string. Well, it's actually not all that long, but you know what I mean? We're just sending one string in there. But you can actually fit in three lines.
Okay.
So what I'm going to do in this example, I'm just going to add another line. So you press, and I've got a colon. I'm going to close that with a thingy, quotation mark, put a comma. So we've got the header, which is continue in uppercase there. So the first line in the message is going to be you pressed, and then the next line is going to be continue.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you know what? Let's mix that up slightly more. Let's just make it look a bit more funky. If we use square brackets and do color, spelt the your way, American way, C-O-L-O-R.
Canadian way.
Equals...
I spell the same way as you.
You spell it the same as us, do
you? Oh, you are? Is that what you're going to say?
You are, yeah.
Yeah, we spell it the same as you guys.
Oh, dear. Oh, that's good.
Yeah. You are right, though. Americans spell it that way.
Yeah. So color equals, that's my favorite one, dodgy blue. I'm a big fan of that. I mean, there's loads of different colors. We can go through those another time. But if we go color equals dodgy blue and then close the square brackets, and then after continue, we just need to close that color. So you do open square brackets, slash.
Yep, color again.
Color.
Yep, excellent.
Yeah.
I've done that before.
Brilliant. So if we save that, let's see how it comes out.
I'm just going to be a second typing this stuff. Sorry, Lee.
Okay.
I'm watching you and trying to type at the same time.
I know, I can be very off-putting, sorry.
You're fine. Roger blue, is that percent?
Stop. Should show nothing. Yep. Brilliant. So mine's working.
Okay, I'm just going to run it now. Nice. Yep, good. Okay, so I get it. Headers at the top of the box.
Yep.
Then you got your little dialogue, and then we changed actual continue to blue. Perfect.
Yeah, yeah. And I tell you what, let's put a little else statement after that. So we'll say else, so otherwise, basically, else with the colon.
In other words, if you click stop instead of continue,
exactly,
this is what will happen.
Okay. And I'm just going to copy that dialogue. Okay, we'll throw it down, throw it underneath the else, and we'll change continue to stop. And I'm just going to change the color to yellow. So a simple if and else is great for the yes no dialogue because you've only got two options. You know, it's either one or zero. So,
yeah,
nice and simple.
I'm going hot pink.
I hear that's Diesel's favorite color as well.
I hear that. All the time.
There we go. Perfect. Make sure the other one's working. Yep. So, yeah, so you can do exactly the same in a yes-no dialogue as well. They all take the same amount of parameters, so you can have a maximum of 3 lines. So we could add, you know, another comma, another string.
Okay, so you're saying, because the stop is the header, 3 more, so 4 technically.
Yeah, 4 in total, yeah. So 1, 2, 3, plus the header, 4. If you try and put another one in, it would just throw an error in the log. It'd say too many statements in there, too many variables in there.
Okay.
But the weird thing is, and this is strange, it is skin dependent on how big the dialog box is, but all of them seem to be able to take at least 4 lines of code, 4 lines of strings.
Okay.
Which is bizarre because there's only room for 3 in your in your code.
Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah.
So what you do is on, let's say on your 3rd line, test line 3, what you would have to do in that case is do open square brackets and then uppercase CR for carriage return, which is enter basically. That's Cody's way of saying that's a, you know, press in enter. That means go on a new line. And then you could continue with test line 4. So if we try that, it's a bit of a hacky way around it, but you know, if you do need more text, that's the way to do it.
Okay.
I'll just test that. So I've done that on a continue one.
Yep, I got all 4.
Yep, yep. I mean, you can keep going. You can put more, but then it starts to scroll and it doesn't look very good.
That looks silly.
It does.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, because it usually starts at the bottom of the text and then you have to wait for it to scroll up so you can read the start of it. Yeah, it's a bit daft.
Okay.
Okay. Now, let's move on to something more exciting that I think you're going to want to play with. Playing videos.
Yep.
Okay. Now, what we're going to need to do is find a link to a video. So I'm just going to go on. I'm going to go over to Google and he says, if I can find Google. All right. And I'm just going to type into Google archive movies. And it should bring up a link for archive.org where they've got some free movies on there, some royalty free, really old stuff. So, what's the link to
just
that?
Just pick any of them?
Yeah, I'm going to, what am I going to here? What's the link?
Oh, I'm using Return of the Kung Fu Dragon.
Oh, that sounds
good. Exciting.
Yeah, I'm going to have that if I see it on there. Yeah. I'm just waiting for it to load up. This is painfully slow. Return of the
Kung Fu. Yeah, it's just you, too, I guess, because, I don't know, are you, because you're hosting, I guess? Because mine's pretty fast.
Yeah, it must be, I guess. I can't see that one. So I'm going to have Babies and Breadwinners. Part 2.
That sounds exciting.
Isn't it
what
just?
The hell? Oh, crap. Okay, I got mine already.
Alright. So we just need to find that the actual final resolved link. So archive's a good one to go to because they don't hide their links. They're actually out in the open. Very, very easy to find. So what I do is once I click on it, if you click on the show all on the right hand side, just in that download options section, it will then show all the files they've got for this particular video. So as you can see, this one I've got here, I've got a GIF where that's you can tell by the size on the right hand side, I mean that's quite a small image file that is, so that's not what we want. MPEG, that would do. OGV, that'd probably do. Not very good quality that. MP4, that's usually a good one to have. Yeah, so I've got those three. I'm going to go for the MP4. So I'm going to right click on that and just do copy link address. Now I'm going to go back to my code and let's add that just up here below our dialogue, and we'll do video equals quotation marks and then paste your link in there. You got that, Shan?
Yeah, I'm good.
Marvelous. Excellent. And what should we do here? Let's comment out that. Right. I'm going to change our yes no question. I'm going to put that as watch movie. Put question mark. Click yes or no. Actually, I'll just change that to do you want to watch Babies and Breadwinners Part 2? Obviously, yours is called something else, so feel free to put
Journey
call
of
it
the Kung Fu Dragon. Yeah,
yeah, yours sounds so much better. Yours sounds actually really cool.
I know everybody's gonna want to borrow mine.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's going to borrow my my one.
Okay, question mark.
Right, so we've got that. And obviously, if they click... Aha, let's change the continue and stop as well, else that'd be confusing. So we'll do... do you want to watch... Well, what I can do, I could just get rid of those labels at the end, because a yes, no is fine. I mean, I could change
them. Totally.
I could change them to yes and no manually in there, but I'm not going
to. Or you could change them to stuff like "I'd love to" and
yeah,
"not
exactly.
a chance."
Yeah,
okay,
yeah, absolutely.
That's awesome. See, they'd want to watch mine.
That's a very good idea. I'm gonna put them
yeah,
back.
Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah, that's a very good idea. Let's do that. So.
Oh crap. Cool.
And so the
this is exciting.
So the dialogue, okay, we're just gonna hash that out, so put a little pound, as you call it, just in front of that one, and move the else down line. Now what's the best way to do this? I suppose let's just write it out long-winded. It's been a long time since I've made something play in XBMC, so hopefully I'll get it right. It's in the XBMC module, so it's XBMC dot, and it's player, it's in the player function of that module, and it's a capital P, uppercase P, and then you do the open close brackets, and then it's dot play, I think, and open brackets, and then we just put our variable in there. So I mean,
video.
Yep, that's it. Exactly. Type video in there. XBMC player play video. Oh, just realised something I've not done on mine. I've not indented it.
Okay.
So. That's better. So save that.
Test it now, or?
Yeah, let's give it a go.
Okay.
May well have messed it up. Like I say, it's been a long time.
I love the little pop-up. That's great.
Oh, it looks promising. Mine's doing something. Yes.
Mine too.
Brilliant. Now, while it's playing, if you press I, you can bring up the information.
Oh, Yep, I'm good to go.
Good afternoon.
Hello.
Marvellous.
Okay.
So if you bring up, if you press I while it's playing, you should be able to see, it's got a very confusing sound. It's got the actual file name, yeah, which isn't very clean.
No, it's gross.
Yeah. So, but how cool was that? We've already started an add-on that plays a video.
That is friggin' cool.
Record timing, I think, for us, isn't it? Yeah. Do you know what? That looks confusing to me. So I'm going to do the same with that XBMC player as I've done with the dialogue. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut XBMC player. So Control X. I'm going to highlight that. Control X. And I'll do player.play. And then up here, we just need to add that as a variable. So player equals XBMC player with your brackets.
That is really handy, variables.
That is. Now, what is it we do here? I think in this player play section, I'm just trying to remember how we put a nice clean name in there. I think if we put a comma followed by a name, that will then give it that clean name when we press the information. So we just give it a go. So what have I got?
So just the name of the movie?
Yeah. Well, you could call it what you like, but yeah, babies and bread winners. And then also that would, I'm fairly certain when you search for subtitles, it would use that as the looking for the subtitles, so it should bring up the correct results.
Okay.
So we give that a go.
Gonna run it.
Yeah, let's see. I'm not 100% sure on that, so we'll soon see.
Check the log.
Yep. Okay. So what I'm gonna have to do is just check the Python documents page. Hold on. So I want the XBMC one. Feel free to check yours as well.
I am. It says non-API typed passed to play in place of the expected type. Not sure what that means.
Right. I'm just looking on that web page. You know, the documents, PY documents.
Okay.
And in there, there's a link to where it says player, the player function. And here we go. So play list item.
Sorry, Lee, which one should I be in? Just XBMC?
Ah, I see. Yeah.
Where you're looking?
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. In XBMC. Yep. I see what I've done wrong. Yep.
Okay. Yep.
Yep. And can you see about halfway down, it says example, and it's got Iron Man in brackets.
Yep.
If you copy that line, that first line.
Like the list item one, the whole line?
Yep. You don't need the little dash. Just the actual
right.
Code.
From L on, okay.
Yep. And then what we're going to need to do is put that, well, we'll put that in that same if statement. So put it just above the player.play. And we change Iron Man to the name of our film. And then we just obviously need to change it in player play. And do you know what it is we're going to put in there?
What's that?
So in that player play video and then a comma, we're going to put list item, which is, because that's a variable that we created. List item equals XBMC GUI list item, and then your title of your movie. So that was why it wasn't working before, because we was putting the title in as it is, and it actually needs to go in as an XBMC GUI list item. Obviously, converts it into something or other.
Okay, so just try it again.
Yeah, give that a go.
Yep, it's working and the name's perfect.
Before the immunization brilliant. Opened, marvelous.
The Junior Chamber of Commerce, yeah, woohoo.
That's great. Canvas.
Oh, this was really neat, though.
So yeah, that makes sense. That's cool, isn't it? Yeah.
Well, it was cool, Lee, because I mean, the other stuff we were doing, it was like you were telling us why we're doing it, and that's great. But when you don't see an end result, it's hard to.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean? It's hard to see it.
Yeah.
Like I like the fact that you can see the dialog box, and you can see where your words go, and you can see what happens when you click the button. That's fantastic. I love it.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what else. Actually, what we can do while we're here. Let's say we want so we in our code there we've got watch movie, do you want to watch such and such, and then we've got the if statement. So let's try embedding another if statement in there. So what we're going to do is, and then we call it a day, what we're going to do in there, we're going to pretend that we've got a trailer for it. Okay, so we're going to offer the option to say, do you want to watch the trailer or the movie?
Okay,
so we leave that first bit as it is, the choice equals, if choice equals one. But what we want to do is under choice equals one, we can actually reuse that same variable if we want. So we can do choice equals, okay, because we've already used choice, we're done with it. Yeah, that statement is over at that point. If choice equals one, we're not going to need that again. So we can assign that to something else now. Is that make sense, or did I just confuse things even more there?
No, it makes sense.
So what we can do, that's what I was going to say, is, you know, I'm just going to copy that line. That'd be easier than typing it out. Need to indent that. So yeah, so we've got our choice at the top there.
Okay.
Do you want to watch the movie? Blah, blah, blah. And then if choice is one, then we continue. And we can reuse that variable again. I mean, we could call this something totally different, but it gets confusing if you start using lots of different variables for essentially just questions, yes or no questions. You end up with loads of them, and it can get a bit out of hand. So you might as well just use the same one over and over again. So we'll do that again. Choice equals dialogue, yes, no, and we change that to, oops. Trailer or watch trailer or movie. Do you want to watch the trailer or the movie? So we do yes label as trailer and no label as movie. And then all we need to do is copy exactly what we've done above. So if choice equals one. Oopsie daisy. But it obviously has to be indented. And then I'm going to. So I'll get rid of that line that I commented out because that's just annoying me. So we'll indent that. So it should look something like that at the moment.
Okay.
And so what that's currently saying is, if we choose yes, yeah. Do you know what? I'll get rid of that equals one. and we just try equals true, so we can test that that method works as well, because one and true are exactly the same as zero and false.
Okay.
So we're saying, do you want to watch the movie or the trailer? So the yes label is the trailer. So we change the name to trailer, and we call that trailer in there, that first variable for player play, and then we're just going to have to put a variable at the top for a trailer. We just make something up, and then we can then do our else statement, which is going to be, oh, I should have copied that, shouldn't I, from before? Oh well. Oh, and can you see what I've done here on this one? I've completely screwed up my settings, obviously.
Because you have spaces and tabs?
Yeah,
is that
yeah.
What you're talking about?
Exactly, yeah.
That's cool that you can see that, though.
That is. That's really useful. So I'm just going to...
Oh, you just click on the number on the side, and it basically highlights it, right? Like you showed us earlier?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah. So I'm going to do the...
Mine's all spaces, it looks like.
Indent using
spaces. Oh, you know why? Because I set it to... remember that thing you showed us the other day?
Yes. Like
setting tab to spaces?
Yeah.
I did that.
Cool. I've obviously switched mine off for some bizarre reason. Right, let's fix that. So else, let's copy that. We'll paste that in there.
Okay, so just copy that whole thing and just change it to movie and movie?
Yeah, so we change that to, it'd be player play video. Because we've already got the variable video set up.
Okay. And then movie,
yeah, or the actual name of the movie, whatever you want to put in there. So all we then need to do here is, let's copy that video one, because I can't actually be bothered to try and find a different video, because my computer's going too slow. So I'm just going to rename that one as... trailer. You see that?
Yep, I'm just changing it too. Good to go. I think I'm good.
Okay, so even though it's going to show exactly the same video in this case, when we press the information button, it should tell us if it's the trailer or the movie, at least. So at least we can see if it's working or not, our code.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or would it be good to go to YouTube and just grab a really fast video?
If you can, yeah, give it a go. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to do that for sure.
My computer's a little bit too slow to do that.
Or can I do that? Can I use a YouTube video? Yeah. We don't need a special code in order to use it, or do we?
Yeah. You might struggle with YouTube, to be honest.
Okay. You know what? I'll leave it alone then.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So try it out.
Hey. Yeah.
Yours running. I can hear something.
Yeah, give it a go. Yeah. Let's try it. Let's see what happens. So, let's see if that works.
Nice. I'm good.
All right. Trailer. Let's see if it does actually say trailer for me.
Before the immunization station opens,
so that bit of code's
the
working.
Chamber of Commerce
says trailer. And what about movie?
And I'm good on both too.
Before the
nice. Very cool.
Perfect. Does that make sense? How we've embedded the if statement inside another if statement there?
Yeah, it totally does.
Cool. Excellent.
Yeah. Because if you had to hit stop, it would have kicked us right back to the last else, right?
Exactly.
It would have jumped right over all the stuff because it wasn't true or it wasn't one.
That's it. Yep. Absolutely.
Okay.
Yep. And like I say, I mean, when I do it, I Usually, these I used to always do equals one, and then I went for a spell of doing equals two, true, and then when I realised actually you don't need either, I just now have it
just,
as
yeah, if know, choice.
If choice, you know, just saves that extra bit, and that
that's
should
awesome.
That should also work. Let's just double check, test.
I'll try it too.
Before the immunization stations open.
Yep. Works perfect.
And that concludes it for week three. Make sure you join us next week when we start to create a directory structure. We'll add directories to our plugin. Using what we learned this week with the video playback, we'll create a plugin that lists various add-ons and also submenus. Thanks for watching and catch up soon.